Larry, what have you done this time? How on earth did this happen? Did you piss off Kira, the Pirate Queen? Because these guys do not look friendly at all. Did you just get yourself into an impossible situation?
And I guess you're going to want me to get you out of the situation, aren't you?
Well, you know what, Larry? It's your lucky day, because it's been a long time since we've done impossible battles. I'm going to be honest with you, Larry. I have yet to do impossible battles with these new god powers, such as the grenade god power. Now, is there a chance that I might blow you up while I'm preparing this grenade sphere? Yeah, it's possible. Larry, do you trust me?
I sure hope you do.
It's like he's wearing a grenade hat. A ginormous grenade hat that's going to explode out in every direction. Now, were all the grenades necessary? No. I mean, all these grenades on the top half aren't even going to, like, hit anything. They're there mostly for style points. Because here in Totally Accurate Battle Simulator, we're all about style points. So, Larry, we're going to deal with your lovely friends, and you better not get yourself into any other impossible situations.
No, knowing you, that's going to happen, Larry.
Here we go. Exploding sphere of grenades in slow-mo.
Maximum slow-mo.
In 3, 2, 1,
go activate.
That's maximum slow-mo. Look how fast they're going.
Collision. What just happened?
What has happened? So in one split second, the grenades were like right here in front of the pirates. And then in the next split second, the grenades moved about 15 feet all the way out here. You can see explosions in multiple waves. You can see the primary explosions on the front guys, the front pirates. And then you can see the secondary explosions on the after pirates. And then a tertiary, which is a third explosion, behind the pirates on the ground. And then a second, or actually a fourth, set of explosions here, further back on the ground. And then this is going to be the fifth set of explosions, or these grenades here, as they impact probably around here. But we didn't get that far. We didn't get that far because Larry just observed, like, watch from Larry's perspective what this looks like. Are you kidding me? You're just sitting there, minding your own business, surrounded by pirates, because that happens, and then boom! Everything is destroyed. Amazing. Hey, Larry.
How's it going?
See, you're at your mansion home. I can't believe you have a farmhouse and a mansion home. Did you know that?
What brings you to this lovely place?
Look at all the hobbits. What did you do, Larry? Let me guess. You called teeny tiny Timmy short again, didn't you, Larry? You know Timmy's sensitive about his height. You gotta stop doing that.
Either way, this is a lot of hobbits. Why are they all standing weird? Hold on a second.
Aw, Larry, you wrote the word subscribe. Aw, you shouldn't have. For every person that subscribes on this video, Larry gets a new potion. Now, I appreciate the generosity, Larry, but we gotta do something about these lovely hobbits because they're gonna march their way towards you. How are we gonna get you out of this situation? Okay, Larry, as a thank you, I tried to write the word subscribe in fireballs in the sky. And I gotta say, it didn't go too bad when you look from this perspective. However, as you drop down, you begin to realize that writing in 3D space is really, really hard to do. Okay, Larry, let's see if we can save your life with a fireball subscribe on top of a hobbit subscribe in 3, 2, 1. Slow motion activate. Look at that. Even in fire, it kind of says subscribe. Full speed, all the hobbits burn, and we were victorious. We wrote a fireball subscribe. That is awesome. Now stop getting into trouble, Larry.
Are you kidding me, Larry? You couldn't go 2 seconds.
Pirate Queen Kira, hey, how are you?
And how are you?
And how are you?
And you? Oh, that's a lot of Pirate Queen Kiras. Oh, that's not good.
Oh, and there's cannons and musketeers and vampires and skeleton archers and ballistas and many of the minotaurs and Zeus's. Oh my God, Larry, what have you done? Hey, your friends are here. Hey guys. Benny, what's up? How you doing? Helga, hello. Bjorn, nice to see you. So you guys won't instantly die. That's good. But Benny's in a bit of a pickle. Just to make sure, we're going to look around. I don't see any little snipers here trying to kill my other friends. Oh, Manny the Mammoth is over here chilling, and a whole bunch of harvesters here as well. So, Larry, how do we get you out of this predicament without killing you? Things like explosions and fireballs are out of the question because you're gonna die if those hit you. It's funny, I'm less concerned about the melee people and way more concerned about these ranged units who just want to open fire on Larry. The harpooners? Not good. The musketeers, including the midget musketeer? Huge problem. Okay, the lag is really bad, but I think I've lined up the first volley of bullets to hopefully incapacitate everyone around Larry and keep him alive in 3, 2, 1. Maximum slow-mo activate. The bullets each move out in rapid succession, hopefully killing everything that wants to take a shot at Larry. Slow motion, I'm just watching very carefully. I'm looking around the entire battlefield trying to find anything that wants to shoot Larry. Pause time. So far, so good. The lag is exceptionally bad right now. I've got about 5,000 bullets on the battlefield. Let's do regular slow-mo. Okay, everything's occurring. Everything's going well. Larry's alive. Actually, can we just go in and verify that Larry's alive? We have confirmation Larry is alive. Slow-mo activate. Try and make time go a bit faster here. Hopefully the smoke can dissipate and we'll be able to actually see. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, no. Did I miss one? Did I miss a single musketeer who took a shot from this side? Did that just kill Larry? No! Larry died! We were so close to perfection. Oh, that was so close. Now, we have a bigger problem to deal with. All these guys. That's a lot of corpses. Luckily for us, we no longer have to worry about the proximity of our lovely enemies. So, yeah, we're going to do some damage here. Say goodbye to this backline. Oh, my God. It's so much lag. There we go. Beautiful explosion. Everything goes flying. Lots of dead units and yet lots of living ones as well. Now, I'm just going to check over here. We have a handful of units. Finally, I can move normally a little bit. And we're just going to say hi with the bazooka rockets. Love it. Absolutely adore it. Please give it to me more. Over here, Manny the Mammoth, you can have a whole boatload of explosions. Oh, that is gorgeous. What about those harvesters? They all moved around this way. Let's give them a beautiful surprise. God powers, please. Just give me more cool god powers. They're one of the most fun parts about this game. Have some more bazooka bombs. Goodbye, Zeus. And then all these Zeuses and Minotaurs. My God. My God. My goodness. There's Bjorn. Carpet bomb. Bjorn, how you doing? How you holding up? You enjoying the show? Helga's dead. Benny's dead. You're the last one alive. I think I've cleared the way for you. Things are looking fantastic over there, Bjorn. A handful of Minotaurs left alive, but that won't be a problem. A whole lot longer. Oh, oh, Zeusie. You came and you gave me explosives. Oh, there's a Zeus. Get out of here, Zeus. Not allowed. Are you dead? Your life? Who's left? Where's Bjorn going? Bjorn! Oh! There's one of these people! Oh! Oh, we did it! Oh, that was almost impossible! We almost lost that battle! That was awesome! Yo, Larry, when did you get to the God Realm? Or is this the Peace Realm? Nah, I'm pretty sure it's the God Realm. That's a lot of ranged units. What on earth? How is this even possible? Look, there's people from all sorts of factions here. Firework archers from the Dynasty. Ice archers from the Vikings, tribal rock throwers, ninjas from the Dynasty, regular archers from the Medieval, and crossbowmen from the Medieval faction. You know what, Larry? Since you're all the way over there, I'm going to try and have a little bit of fun here. It's raining apples. Hallelujah. It's raining apples. Usually when I do these attacks, they always come in a certain specific kind of fashion. But sometimes I just want to do things a little bit differently. So what I'm doing is 100 apples in a bundle, 45 degrees spread from the sky. Because I want to see how this looks or fun in 3, 2, 1. Slow mode activate. It's raining apples, baby. We didn't instantly win. How did anything survive this many apples raining from the sky? Oh, the crossbowmen are a little bit durable. Look at that. One ninja, a handful of crossbowmen. Oh, a bunch of crossbowmen. They are way more durable than I expected. So since that didn't work, what if I just do... Oh, that might have been a mistake. Guys, I held alt. That is a bunch of apples. Here we go. Slow-mo. Spread. Apple spread. Apple spread. Apple spread. I love it. All right, let's get these units into the hallway a little bit. There we go. There we go. Stop. Hold on. This is thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of apples. 3, 2, 1. Slow-mo. Activate. Oh, they're like funneled down the way. Oh my god, look at the sheer number of apples. I love god powers.